Hello guys, in this tutorial, I will show you my Tileable skin method for creating realistic skin pores. I will explain all my nodes set up for realistic skin. And this is part 1. If you guys support this channel and this tutorial, I will create a full series for the skin. In this part, I will explain about skin displacement and detail. If you want to learn how to create super realistic characters, continue watching this tutorial. Okay guys, let me explain what will make a skin realistic. We always have three layers of displacement. Micro, secondary, and significant details. Micro and secondary are the pores and lines between pores or skin holes. Significant details are like lips wrinkles. Okay, let me explain the nodes, so you can understand what's going on. First, we have texture nodes. We use texture nodes to import our Tileable skin pores alphas. Remember to change the color space to none color because our alphas are black and white. We have multiply nodes for controlling the intensity of our details. If I change the value, the skin detail's intensity will change. We have add nodes also for mixing our alphas and details together. We have also texture coordinates for scaling our skin pores. Now, if I change the values, you will see the skin pores will change. As you can see, when I change the values, the skin pores intensity will change. I also created a mask to separate the nose and lips because the nose and lips don't have a lot of skin holes. We can add the details and wrinkles when we are in sculpting mode, then we can add them in a significant detail layer after. I will show you my mask setup also, so you can understand what's going on. I know it's a little bit confusing, but when you understand the concept behind it, you can create hyper-realistic characters in Blender. As you can see, when I change the mapping node scale, the size of the pores change, and because we have Tileable Alpha, you can easily change the scale of your pores. Okay, now let me show you my mask for the details. As you can see, my background is gray because when I mix the pores, I want all three layers. Just select a brush and paint white the area you don't want the micro and secondary details. The white areas don't have any micro and secondary details. You can save your mask, add the mask to the texture node, and connect the texture node to the FAC. This mask will separate your details. As you can see here, we have all types of pores for skin alphas, pores lines, generic skin pores, skin holes, and more. This method is the best method for skin texturing in Blender. You don't have to subdivide your model million times like other tutorials tell you. You can easily tile and manage the details with masks. The secret behind the realistic skin is only details. If you manage to make your details realistic, your character will be realistic too. You can also create killer roughness maps with these Tileable alphas. Alright guys, let me show you and try some of these Tileable alphas in real time. Alright, guys, this is the final character. As you can see, we have a very realistic character. I will tell you all the steps again. If you want realistic skin, you should have 3 layers of displacement. Micro displacement, medium displacement, and large displacement details. Small, medium, and large. You can call it anything you want. Micro is for tiny skin pores. Medium is for skin lines and skin holes. Large details are for facial pimples and wrinkles. You should sculpt large details yourself, but for micro and medium, you should use Tileable alphas. If you do these 3 steps right, you will have realistic skin. I tried my best to tell you everything I knew. I hope you guys give me some love back with likes and comments. If you have any questions, please ask in the comment section below. Let me know what tutorial I should create for the next video.